Is there a state in Australia that is funnier than all the rest? Is it WA? Maybe it's Tassie. Well, right now, Melbourne is laughing harder than the rest of us. It's all thanks to the Melbourne Comedy Festival. And joining us this morning from Melbourne are three of the star players. Please welcome Claire Hooper, Frank Woodley and Merrick Watts.
Hi, guys.
Hey.
Oh, stop it. Oh. No, keep it going. It's good.
Thank you so much for being part of our crazy little show. Hey, Are you often asked, can you just be funny? Like, yeah. Are you guys funny in real life or just on the stage?
I'd say, I reckon most comedians are pretty funny in real life around their partners, around their family, because if they're not, then they're just doing comedy for catharsis, and that's not very funny at all. That's therapy in front of a group. So, no, I think if you ask my wife, I'm hilarious all the time. Yeah. I never stop being funny.
Yeah, I can vouch for that.
I reckon most of us are comedians because our families have told us to take it outside the house, please. You know, like our families want a break from it.
I refuse to be funny, except when I'm performing. I save it all up. I actually spend most of my time just with my mouth like a cat's bum.
Yeah. I refuse to be funny even when I am performing. there's been heaps of discussion recently about, you know, comedians saying they won't perform at certain places because they're worried about the backlash or that people are too politically correct or too quick to outrage. Do you guys worry about that when you're doing an act? Like, Merrick, you're a pretty free-wheeling kind of guy. Do you worry about, you know, whether or not you're going too far and whether or not there'll be a backlash on social media, stuff like that?
Sometimes you've got to be careful about what you say, and sometimes people take things out of context, and that's the biggest problem for me, would be somebody taking something out of context. But I don't do jokes about Donald Trump or politics or racism or any of the kind of contentious issues. I just do jokes about how much of a nightmare my family is and how much of a nightmare I am living within my own skin. So I don't have to worry about offending anyone. I'm too busy offending myself.
Mahatma Gandhi said, if you're making everybody happy, you can't be being true to yourself.
Yeah. Yes.
You know, he was a grown man wearing a nappy, so maybe we should take that with a grain of salt. But a grain of salt, taking something with a grain of salt, that's not going to make much difference, is it? Like one grain. I think that, anyway, push on.
You started him.
Yeah.
And Claire, what about you though? Are there some jokes that you would avoid doing?
Look, I'm just concerned about maintaining the close relationships I have. So if my husband says something's off limits, then it's off limits, even though he did something unreal last week and then immediately went, you can't use it. I'm like, it's killing me.
What was it?
Say it on telly. Say it on telly.
Make it out as if it was your another friend or someone.
Oh, my God. Oh. Although, to be honest, I'm telling a lot of jokes about my mother-in-law in my show this year, and I'm really worried about that. Beautiful relationship.
Yeah, no, I wouldn't worry. Like, relationships with mothers-in-law, I mean, historically, they're really... Yeah, there's never fragility there.
That's right. I'm meant to ruin that one, aren't I?
Now, Merrick, you're all friends, but you're also in direct competition.
Yeah.
Are you nice to the people and do you tell them how good they are when they come
sabotage.
Up?
Sabotage.
Or do you... Yeah, you sabotage.
Oh, of course. Of course I do, Denise. I'm never sincere about it, but I always tell them that they're doing a great job. Because it is very competitive, so my point of difference is to not be as good as anybody else, but be twice as handsome, and I think I've pulled that off. So.
Yeah. Oh, stop it, you're right. It was quite annoying for me, actually. The show after mine is Daniel Kitson, and I ran about half an hour long on Sunday, and so the last half hour of my show was the first half hour of his show. He just came on, and it really annoyed me because he was much better than me for the last half hour of my show. That almost made sense. I'm going to go away. I'm going to do a second draft.
Yeah, rewrite.
Let's meet back here tomorrow, and I'll nail that.
All right, before you go, guys, I want you all to give me a quick elevator pitch. Why should we come see you at the Comedy Festival? Merrick, go.
Because it's funny and it's relatable, and because I'm there and I'm hosting it, so I'd be there if
and
I were
you're
you.
Handsome.
Or if just that was a pretty good sell. I reckon I nailed that one.
Yeah.
Over Frank? You know that.
Well, I mean, just come if you look. Laughter's the best medicine. Although if you're hit by a bus at that point, you don't want to hear somebody making their way through the crowd going, "Stand back, I've done some stand-up." But look, I think actually I would recommend have a look and find a really good review of a comedian you've never heard of before and go and see, discover something new, because there's
No, go to my show. What are you doing?
I'll go to Merrick's show.
It's a stupid idea.
You've got to get to Claire.
I think we're going to be fine. We're going to be fine.
No, I'm the comedian you haven't heard of that he was talking about. Comedyfestival.com.au, book tickets now.
Yeah, guys, it's fab. Claire's show is called Familiar and Merrick's is Man of the House. They're on it at Melbourne Town Hall until the 23rd of April. You can also catch Frank's show, I Woodley, at the Arts Centre until this Sunday. You can find all the information about shows and tickets for the Melbourne International Comedy Festival online. You can head to comedyfestival.com.au. Thanks for the laughs, guys.
Yay!
See you guys.